And joining us from Melbourne is Sophia Frenz from Melbourne University. She is currently researching a PhD, conveniently, in this exact area. Sophia, just how monumental is this?
So, like, while it is a big move, and I certainly don't want to undermine what this could mean for people suffering from mitochondrial disorders, it's not amazing and wonderful and perfect. It's just something that we need to keep an eye on and a step in the right direction.
I mean, not that long ago, there was a lot of controversy around IVF, but now it's very common for couples with fertility problems rather to undergo IVF. So do you think that in a few years' time, I don't know, will it be commonplace for babies to be born with the DNA of three people?
Well, there are a few things that say that maybe it'll be a bit longer than a few years. So firstly, the fact that mitochondrial donors and the creation of children using them was legalised in the UK relatively recently, but that was after 10 years of research and, like, battling by lobby groups in order to make that happen. I don't think it'll be really quick, but I think it will be a really good thing for families for which there is no other option.
Now, obviously, the legalities around a baby being created in this very specific way are quite complex. And I'm curious, legally speaking, could this child have been born in Australia?
No.
Right. Should it have been able to have been born in Australia, in your view?
I don't believe so. I think there has been really, really good research done in the UK, and that's one of the reasons that mitochondrial donor babies were legalised there, is that groundbreaking research has been done in labs in the UK. We don't have that very specific knowledge that means that we'd be best placed to create these children.
I mean, I guess the worry is that the tech will sort of lead to designer babies. I mean, theoretically, if we're not the tallest of human beings. If we, say, wanted a tall baby, could this technology kind of deliver that?
Not at all, actually. The mitochondria have their own genome, which is why these are sort of colloquially referred to as three-parent babies. But it doesn't mean being tall. It doesn't even mean being good at sports. It just means not having a child with a debilitating illness that typically causes death before the age of 20, which is really, really good, but it's not really down the route of designer babies. It's just avoiding disease.